Hello together.
Now I'm here with Dusan Mihic, and Dusan is responsible on global level for the race to revenues across the world. So he is really the person who is creating with the team the whole content. And we are now, let's say, we finished the Race to Revenue workshop here in Heidelberg with our SuccessFactors partners, Business by Design partners, and S4HANA Cloud partners. So Dusan, what is your, let's say, call to action for our internal teams as well for our partners after the workshop?
Yeah, so right now everyone has finished the workshop. What we say when the workshop is over is that Race to Revenue actually begins the moment they leave the workshop office space today. So we have three very specific call to actions that partners need to complete before they start building pipeline. Number one is the sales play approval. Mm-hmm. Hopefully they would have done that during the workshop and during the sales review pit stop. So congratulations to the partners that have completed that. For the ones that haven't, you still have an opportunity to get that done. We hopefully want to see that done in the next week or two. The second call to action is that we want the digital tactics launch. Marco Arguez, our global marketing specialist, will walk them through that today. If they don't get that done today, they can also do that after the workshop. We do require a screenshot of proof that they have launched their digital tactic, and then we will get them approved on that step. And the third and final step that needs to be completed after the workshop is a business-focused sales presentation that a partner can and should use early on in the sales cycle. So to repeat once again, three specific call to actions: sales play approval, digital tactic approval, and then of course the sales presentation approval.
Wow, so that's a clear list for each and everybody what he needs to fulfill now in the next couple of weeks. So that we really can achieve the major goal, yeah? And the major goal for Race to Revenue is what?
So we have only measured two things. So this is not training and enablement. We don't like to call it that. Mm-hmm. We call it a partner pipeline generation program. So the two things that we measure are pipeline. And what comes after pipeline?
Revenue.
Oh. So the two things that we measure success with is pipeline and revenue created through the sales plays developed through the program. Now what that means is partners aren't at it alone. The PBMs are along the journey the whole way. So the PBMs need to help them complete those three action items that we just talked about. And then once they complete those steps, the next step is the PBMs should be holding the hands of the partners, bringing them to the SAP sales teams, and introducing those sales plays that the partners have created so that the teams can get familiar, the SAP teams get familiar with the sales plays. Mm-hmm. And that they can work together, both the partner and the SAP sales teams, to create pipeline, which will create revenue. So the whole concept of 1+1=3, and that whole concept of working together and partnering with SAP and the SAP partners.
Okay, and we are talking here about the race, so which means that at the end, normally in a race, there's a winner. So how we measure them and what will be done so that we can see the progress from I think you will measure lap by lap.
Correct.
So that's one thing. How will this be executed?
So what's different about Race to Revenue and being a partner pipeline generation program and not training and enablement is we have weekly reports and bi-weekly reports that will be sent out to the partners, to the PBMs, and to leadership like yourself, where we track the progress of the laps, the three laps that need to be completed. Again, that's the sales play, digital tactic, and sales presentation. Once that's complete, then we start picking up on what pipeline is created. So what we require from the partners and from the PBMs is all opportunity IDs that are created from the sales plays, filter that up to the race owners, whether it's Ranjit or Rainer or yourself, and then send that over to the global team where we have that in our global spreadsheet. And then during those weekly reports, we actually will show a table of who's at the top, who created the most opportunities and the most revenue potential, and it goes down from there. And at the end, whoever created the most pipeline and the most revenue is the winner of races. And I know you had some very nice surprises last year for some of our partners, and I'm sure you've got some more in store for this year.
Yes, so for your information, last year winners, it was in March, we visited the Elbphilharmonie in Hamburg, which was really a very nice event, and we had dinner together and a lot of fun. So, and similar thing will be also then the prize for the top three partners for the 2019 race. So please stay tuned, and we will share the criteria in detail, and we also will announce then the award in the next, let's say, 2 months, to make sure that there's also a celebration event at the end of the race for the winners. With that, Dusan, any final comment from your side?
My final comments is don't let up. Don't take your foot off the gas. Partners, there's no better way to develop pipeline. There's no simpler method to develop pipeline out there. Pipeline creation is all about hard work. We've made that hard work simple and easy for you. Take advantage of the SAP experts. Take advantage of Jürgen and his team to develop the pipeline. And hopefully we can see you at the top of the table and see you celebrating with Jürgen in 2020.
Okay, I think this was a perfect closing sentence or the closing words. With that, thank you very much for all your effort, your passion, your work you have done for the Race to Revenue. We like it. And therefore, we will share with you the results and see what's going on. And I'm sure also 2020 we will do something together. With that, thanks and
see you later. Thanks for having us.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.